Okay, I'm heading out. Alrighty. It's kind of cold, low key, not gonna lie. All right, let's get on the road. Is this setup gonna even work? I haven't filmed in the car in so long, y'all. Okay, that took forever to set up, but hi, lovelies. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about TikTok things because, and I hate this setup by the way, because I did this so last minute because I was like, I need to get up a video. It's been 3 weeks since I uploaded and I'm so inconsistent. So here we are in my car because my room is a messy home studio. So, basically, shoot, there's people driving by. Oh, today we're gonna talk about TikTok because we're coming up on 6 months of being on the app, consistently posting every day, and we're almost at 100K, so that's pretty cool. Which I'm dropping merch pretty soon, so keep an eye out for that. Follow my Instagram so you can see all the updates. So, in case you don't follow my TikTok or you just have not watched my whole journey, I started TikTok seriously, maybe at the beginning of April. And I had downloaded the app back in January just to kind of play around with it because I work with social media management sometimes, and I'm just like, yeah, I just wanted to see what it looked like, you know, how does the app work? What does it do? I was like, yeah, I need something creative to do, so I started doing that. And 6 months later, here we are. In all honesty, I never expected TikTok to work out like that because obviously my YouTube is still pretty small and I've been doing YouTube for 2 years. It just never blew up or anything. YouTube is honestly a little bit overcrowded just because it's been a site for so long. You know, it's been around for a while. TikTok, on the other hand, is just getting. So there's that. So I guess I'm supposed to tell you guys how you're supposed to grow on there or something. Okay, there's a bunch of softball players having practice and I don't like them looking at me. If you don't go viral overnight or in a week or in a month, there's so many components to making a viral TikTok that you can't really predict what's gonna go viral and what's not gonna go viral. You can, but you can't. Sometimes it's really random stuff that you don't really think is gonna be noticed by anybody. Sometimes it's really poor quality videos too. It doesn't always have to be this perfect latest iPhone film, yada yada. So yeah, I would just say don't get disappointed if you don't go viral super fast. It takes consistent posting in order to work with the algorithm as well, even though there are a few people that I've seen that literally have posted maybe three videos and the third one went viral. So it really depends. You can't predict too much. Another thing I would say is make sure you're having fun on the app because social media is supposed to be fun. It's not supposed to be this whole thing of let's go viral because social media, it's called social for a reason. You know, you're supposed to be connecting with people, having fun with a given video. You can do so many different things. So I would say make sure you're actually having fun because once you lose that aspect of you actually being happy with the videos you're making or you laughing at the videos you're making, I think you kind of lose the whole momentum that could get you going as a video creator. So don't just copy other people's trends. Copy the trends, obviously use the trending audio because that's part of the algorithm, but do not just do things for views. If you're not happy with the content you're making, what can we say? It will show through the views, the likes, people will know. Something I don't think I talked about is how my experience was before I got to 10,000 followers. It was a very frustrating process because I was kind of doing it for fun, and then I started getting follows. I started having this little fan base of concentrated followers and I was like, oh my gosh, they love me. I have to keep growing and this could be so much bigger, right? So I tried to do things for views and some of them did work and some of them didn't. And you know, I think I had to take my focus away from the numbers before I actually started blowing up. Don't focus on the numbers so much. Don't focus on the likes so much because it will, in fact, frustrate you so much. It is not where we're supposed to be focused on. We should be focused on having fun, creating content that we love personally. And it wasn't until July that I hit 10K. And you know, I had been on the app for 3 months at 3 months at that point. So you know, it took a while, and some people, and keep in mind, everyone grows at different speeds on TikTok. My friend Ian, he hit 100K after about a month of consistent posting. At that point, he was just shooting up content every single day. He posted 10 videos a day, I kid you not. And then there's my friend Christine, They're both, by the way, Christine and Ian are both at the same point right now. They both just passed 1 mil, so congrats. But Christine literally didn't post that consistently, and she still got to 1 milli in really, really, really short amount of time. Just everyone's journey is going to be a little different. Focus on yourself. Don't just be looking around at your TikTok friends or other creators and being like, oh my gosh, I can't do this. Because you most certainly can. So. Lastly, I kind of just want to answer a question that I get asked a lot, and that is, should you make a hype house? Should you get a group of creator friends? Yes. But you don't have to. I would say don't just like grab a bunch of people and force them to be friends. That's literally not a good idea. Yeah. But definitely, like, if you find that you and your mutuals, especially if you and your mutuals like are all kind of mutuals. What I mean by that is like there's like I'm part of two hype houses. If you did not know, I'm part of the Blasian house and the Rice house, and the way we all kind of came together was a lot of us were in the same mutuals circles, if that makes sense. Rice House, there was a bunch of Japanese related creators that are all following each other, and it just kind of came together that way. Same thing with the Blasian House, there's a bunch of Blasians that just happen to find each other and we're like, oh yeah, let's do this. So it can definitely help, especially like, it's hard to explain TikTok life to your IRL friends. Like, just speaking from experience, it's very hard to explain it to them. If you've got creator friends, they totally understand that whole thing. And then another thing is bouncing off ideas, doing collabs, because collabs also are a huge, huge part of, like, TikTok. The algorithm itself loves when people do it. So they can also help you keep sane and stay grounded as a creator, because, like, so many things can happen if you're, like, starting to go viral, or if you're just, like, not getting views. You need someone to talk to who will understand those things. If you've stayed this long, thank you, because I literally had no structure to this video. I literally just talked about my TikTok experience. As a media studies student, that's kind of part of the whole thing. So all my social media links are down below. Let me know in the comments any thoughts you have or any other questions about TikTok that you have, because I'm going to try to start doing more social media-ish videos. Just because, like, I am a media studies student and a lot of people do ask me a lot of social media related questions. So, and I will be dropping merch. That's crazy. Like, in about a week or so. Ooh! Until then, keep shining bright, lovelies. Your light never goes unnoticed. And I'll see you on TikTok or Instagram. And hopefully I'll have another YouTube video up in a couple weeks. So, yeah. See you. Gotta drive home now. Bye!